It's The Hot Seat, and I'm Will Xavier. The three C's of blogging are content, community, and commercial sustainability. Selling ads are great, but somewhere in the back of their mind, all bloggers want to be like the Huffington Post, which recently got sold for $300 million.
I think the blog, to me, has always been my hobby. It would be nice if I can sell it for a couple of million bucks. That means I can retire and just sip pina coladas on the beach.
How would that day come? Do you have to move the blog in a particular direction in order to make that possible?
It's very hard to make money from a blog. The advertisers don't treat it like the usual media. It's very difficult to attract advertisers. It's just like writing a book. I mean, I just published a book. A publisher told me, look, you're going to just write a book. Don't expect to earn money out of it because Singapore is so small. There's not enough people who will buy your book in order for you to make a living out of it. You can't retire. So people here publish books because they just want to publish a book.
Is the blogger a journalist? How good a writer do you need to be a good blogger?
This is something I've got to tell you. There's this wonderful definition of what blogging is all about. And it goes something like this. Never before in the history of the world has so much been said by so many to so few. It means to say that, you know, a lot of people blog, but very few people actually read what they blog. For a lot of people, it's a personal diary. Lots of words have been written, but only very, very few blogs actually make it to the top 10 or top 15 or 20 blogs where people actually read it, where they actually have an impact on society or, in my case, an impact on the restaurant and the food industry. Even when you are able to have a few thousand people reading your blog, in Singapore at least, the population is just so small that, you know, advertisers say, okay, how many people do you have reading your blog? Tell them about 6,000 every day. You get 90,000 unique visitors. Then you go, oh yeah, 90,000, that's not very much, you know. We'll pay you this amount, which is usually peanuts. You know, you can't make money out of it.
Pay you for?
Putting an ad on the blog. It is not easy to get the ad money. So anybody who wants to go into blogging, you do it because you enjoy it. You're interested in it. You're passionate about a certain topic or subject that you want to write about.
I think it's too strong to say that blogs are in permanent or complete decline. But if it can be understood from the standpoint that it is survival of the fittest, only the better blogs are still around, and there have been success stories, surely, your blog is only as good as the amount you put into it, right?
The blogs that have been around and are successful usually have very good content. It's not the personal blogs that people write about their lives or whatever. It's a wonderful opportunity for anyone who wants to be a writer to be a writer. Never even dream about that I wanted to publish a blog. I did, however. I'm very interested in photography. And the photography aspect of my blog is that's what drives me. I really
would be remiss if we
world.
Didn't tell everybody that your blog was in fact I eat.
I shoot, I post. The I eat portion is the excuse to I shoot. Then the I post is I have to write something because I shot what I ate. If you put a picture up and you don't tell people what it is, then it doesn't make sense either. When I write, I always ask myself the question, what does the reader want to know? Which is why I go into a lot of the history, the background stories of all the hawkers that I interview. Ask them, you know, how many generations has it been? What kind of secrets do you have? Where's your kway teow from? Do you do something special to your garlic? You know, one of the questions that I asked before was, why is chui kway called chui kway? Chui means water. Kway is a cake, right? Water cake. So I went to talk to the chui kway uncle, and he said, because when you steam the cakes, there's a dimple on top of each one, and that's where the water gathers. So I took a picture of the chui kway with the puddle of water on top, put it up on my blog, and said, this is why chui kway is called chui kway.
We're going to find out whether or not today's blogger is tomorrow's food critic, and do people take what Leslie says seriously? I'm sure his patients do, but do his readers? For now, though, his third musical choice is going to be
a song which, I guess it's quite a few songs in the same genre. I grew up in a school where we had a little red hymn book that my son now carries. He's going to my old school. So I picked this song because it reminded me of my 10 years in a mission school. This is a classic that was popularized, I guess, by Elvis Presley, but I guess it was popular even before him. Carrie Underwood did a newer rendition of it, which I thought was very nice. So this song really does help me to focus my attention on God and to see how big He is, how small I am, and how irrelevant life can be unless He's in the picture.
Then I shall bow in humble God, how great thou art.